It's Hannah, and today I'm going to show you how to make this really cute button loop. You like it? You like it? Yes. But I like this closure for a friendship bracelet because I think it's a really nice alternative closure to just a plain loop. I think it looks a lot more professional and it's finished off nicely, and I think I will be doing it on most of my bracelets from now on. This tutorial is just for this loop here. If you want to find out how to make the bracelet, you are going to have to tune in for my next video so you can see how to make the bracelet. But yes, with all that being said, let's just get on with the tutorial, shall we, and enjoy the change in nail varnish colour. I'm so professional. Okay, so I am starting out by having my colours, and I have my very outside colour, which is this red here, and I've popped that off to the side. I have made that half a metre longer than I've made the other ones. All the other strings are 2 metres long. They are folded in half. This one is 2.5 metres. It's screwed up in a ball, and I will come back to him shortly. So, as I said, I have folded these in half, and so you need to find your most centre colour. This is, as far as I know, this only works on bracelets with even number of strings, but I haven't tried it on an odd number of strings, so I might be wrong. So I'm going to take my most centre colour, which is one of these goldy colour ones here. I'm just going to pull him out because I don't need him right this second. Well, I do, but not in the mix. And then I'm going to do a lark's head knot, which is simple to do. You simply pop the loop through like so, and then you pull the strings through the loop and make sure that that is as central as it gets. Mine has moved slightly, so I just need to scoot that along a little bit. And so that is your central knot. You might find it easier to turn it the other way. Then I'm going to take my next central colour, which is red, and I'm just going to do this one side at a time. So I'm going to take this red, and I'm going to form a loop at the front here, like so, then put the rest of the thread behind, over the top of all the other threads, and back down through that loop, if that makes sense. Getting in a tangle with my threads. Not intentional. Right. Right. And then you just pull this end, and so it scoots along next to that other knot we made. And as I say, I'm just going to do this one side at a time, and then I'll go back and do the other side. So now my next most central colour is another one of this goldy colour. So once again, making a loop at the bottom, bringing the thread behind the other two threads, and bringing that thread through over the top of those other threads and through the loop, and getting in a tangle. And pull that down. Like so. And then my next colour is the green, so I'm just going to repeat that over the remaining gold colour. So I'm going, making a loop in the front, going up behind that gold thread, over the top of the gold thread, and through the loop that has been created. And pull that through. Like so. Nice and tight, and scoot it up and tighten it there, like so. Now I'm just going to repeat that on this other side in the reverse order of that. So starting with the red again, so I guess it is in the same order. Starting with the red, going underneath all the other threads, up and over, and pulling through that loop. And scooting it along. And repeat with the gold. And finally the green. Lovely stuff. Right, now we need to attach that final red colour and we need to create our loop, because you may notice that we currently don't have a loop. So what you're going to do, as we don't have our loop, is you're going to take the colour that's remaining that you haven't knotted at all, and you're simply going to cross them over at the top so your gold threads are swapping sides. So switch those sides over. And I've crossed them over at the top here. I haven't knotted them or anything. They are simply crossed over. Then I am taking my red thread. I have folded it at the 1 meter mark. So I folded it. So one half has 1.5 meters and the other half only has 1 meter. And we are going to do a lark's head knot here. So that's the same as we did before, creating the loop like so. Making sure you're going over both of these threads that we've crossed over and pulling the thread through the loop. Do, 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 do. Come on, cooperate with me. There we go. And then you can scoot that round so it's on one side. The only thing that you need to make sure when you are doing this loop is that the thread that is longer than the other half, so the 1.5 meter length, instead of the meter length, is on this side. Okay, so this thread here is my meter length. I'm just sticking that down there for now. And this is my 1.5 meter length. This is the one we are knotting. So let's get knotting. We are going to start out by putting our thread over the gold threads like so, and then bringing the tail end through that gold loop and up through the red loop. And pull it all through and make sure it's nice and straight underneath, and just lightly tighten that. And then we are going to take the red thread and go underneath those gold threads. Bring the thread through the gold loops and then take it through the red loop. Get any hair out. Make sure that you are knotting over both of the gold threads that you have tightened, or that you've looped over each other even, and make sure they are nice and tight so you don't get any loops in between. So now we're just going to repeat that. So starting out, putting the thread over the top of the gold, pull the red thread through the gold loops, and then take it round the gold thread and up through the red, like so. And pull it down. And then we're going underneath, pull it through, and then through those that red loop again. So I'm just going to repeat these two knots until this is long enough for me to fit my button through, which is this very lovely decorative button here. I'm just going to keep knotting this red thread over the top of this gold thread until it's long enough to fit this button through, and then I shall be back to show you how to do the very next step. So we are at this stage. If I fold this and leave a bit of the gap at the bottom, I am easily able to fit my button through. So now all we have to do is hold your knot at the top, not too tightly obviously, and pull on the gold thread one side, and that will close up that side. And then hold your knots on the other side and give this one a bit of a tug, and that will close up the knots on that side. Double check that your button still fits through. If it doesn't, it is easily rectified. Ease your work up on one side and then continue to tie the knots around until it does fit through. The reason that it stopped fitting through is because when you pull the thread, your knots squeeze together quite a lot. And yes, so you can ease up on one side and then see if it fits through. Now I know that all I have to do is knot the remaining length of here, and then it should fit. So here is my finished loop. I simply filled in that gap that I just made, and now my button fits through perfectly. So that is how you make a loop with a square top, or with a straight top, I suppose I should say. Now you're ready to start knotting. All your threads are in the right order. And yes. So now you know how easy it is to make a friendship bracelet loop of your very own. It's super duper easy. I really, really like this method because it is so easy. I learned it on friendship-bracelets.net. I will link the original post to where I found the idea down below. I got the inspiration from Pinterest actually, and then clicked through to that friendship bracelet website, which is a wonderful website. So if you do enjoy friendship bracelet making, be sure to check out that site. There are so many patterns for everything pretty much. If you did enjoy this video, don't forget to give it a big old thumbs up. And also don't forget to subscribe. I post a new craft tutorial here every Sunday and sometimes a bonus one in the week as well. So I would love it if you would check it out and hit subscribe. If you want to see my videos pop up in your subscription feed every week, which I'm sure you do, then yes, be sure to hit subscribe. If you decide to recreate anything using one of my tutorials, I would love to see a picture of it, so please feel free to post a picture on social media using the hashtag #thecornerofcraft. This means that I can go and check out your makes, see how talented you all are. It's amazing. I love seeing your recreations of my tutorials. It warms my heart. There's no other way of saying it. Be sure to leave any video requests in the comment section below and check out the description box to links to all of my social media as well as any extras that I think you might need. I haven't popped a link to where I bought my embroidery thread from because I've had this embroidery thread for so many years now. I don't even know where I bought them from anymore, so I haven't popped a link in for that, so sorry about that. I think that is everything I have to say. Like, subscribe, social media. Yep. Thank you very much once again for watching, and I shall see you very soon in my next video. Bye! Hey everyone, it's Hannah, and today I'm going to show you how to make this really cute brick stitch dolphin. I was asked way back in January to make a brick stitch dolphin, and I never got around to making the tutorial because I'm super duper organized. But I'm making it now, so I win.